Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Kim Weisskopf's grisly tale of detachment. An arm's length. Starring Dick Sargent. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by Dial Soap, Monroe Shock Absorbers, Camphophonique, the makers of Kodak cameras, and Breck Shampoo. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Today, the story of a puzzle. There's one last missing piece and a host of peculiar folks involved in the search. We will soon meet Police Detective Lieutenant Dan Wilson, a hard-nosed cop with a sports page fixation. Dan Wilson's job will be to find just what it is that lies an arm's length away. Picture this, a lakeside mountain resort. It's mid-morning, and the sun is barely breaking through the cloud cover.
Never again do we spend a weekend in the pines. Nothing but rain. We could have stayed home and watched television for all the relaxation we've had.
Stop complaining, Harry. It was lovely just being where the air's clean.
Are you packed?
Not quite.
Then what are you doing outside? Tell me, we could check out now. We could get back to the city before the traffic gets too bad.
I want to get a souvenir to take home.
Souvenirs? Might as well scoop up a mud pie. That'd be the thing to remind me of this weekend.
Don't tell me Ruth was the greatest. Aaron's the best that ever lived. Now look at the stats. He can hit, run, hit with power, steal base.
Yeah, but can he pitch? Ruth was a great pitcher.
I don't want to hear about it. Wilson homicide. What? Where? When? We're on the way.
Where are we going?
Lake Alston, Dodger Lodge. They found Ed Slito. Most of them, anyway.
What do you mean?
His pitching arm. It's missing. That's him, all right. Tattoos and all. Sergeant, where's the couple that found the body?
In the other room. Name of Ryan, guy who runs the place. Van Ness, he's in there with him.
Thanks. We'll take it from here. Nolan, you all right?
It'll pass.
You, Van Ness?
Oh, yes. This is terrible. Have you any idea what the publicity would do?
Where's Ryan?
I'm Harry Ryan. Who are you?
Detective Lieutenant Wilson. This is my partner, Sergeant Nolan.
Well, it's about time. We spent our whole weekend knee-deep in mud. Our ice chest is stolen.
Save it for your memoirs. We got a dead man in the other room, and I'm missing the ball game on the radio, so we all got problems. Now, what happened out here?
Harry?
That's my wife. She had to find the damn thing.
Harry?
Ma'am, my name's Wilson. Could you tell me just what happened?
Oh, I was looking for a souvenir, something to bring back home. I bent down to look at a pine cone, and there was this hand. Oh, it was awful.
Nolan, will you get over here? I can't handle hysterical women.
Oh, thanks.
You too. Let's give them some privacy. Van Ness, you know who this is, was.
I don't know how he got here, who he was. All I know
is
that...
Fine, fine. What about you?
Lieutenant, I demand to know why we're being detained. All he wanted to do was...
Great. Now I'll write that down in my mind. This one-armed corpse is Tattoo Ed Slito, one of the great prison team baseball pitchers of all time. Boy, now look at him.
Lieutenant, must you...
Now, why would somebody want to go and do that to such a great talent? He pitched for them all. Chino, Quentin, Fulton...
Lieutenant, can I see you outside?
Sure.
I got Mrs. Ryan's statement and home address. I think we can let him go for now.
Kind of nice up here, isn't it? Rustic.
You get anything out of those two?
The guy's been in the joint most of his life. His mother's still alive.
You lost me.
Let's go.
Go? Go where?
Back to the city. For some answers.
I'm going where?
To every tattoo parlor on the Bowery until you find the one where Slito got that arm marked.
But the arm, it's gone. We don't know what was on it.
But we do know who put it on. Rembrandt Landy was the only one Slito trusted with his body. Find him and find out what he drew on that arm and when.
And where will you be?
I'm going to look up Slito's mother. She makes great cupcakes.
So you haven't seen any of this time out, Mrs. Slito?
Would you like another cupcake, Officer Wilson?
No.
I'm surprised Eddie didn't write to tell me he was being sprung again. He always lets me know in advance so I can stock up the Frigidaire.
Do you have any photographs of Ed around here, Mrs. Slito?
Well, naturally, I'm his mother. Now, let's see. This is Eddie when he was 5. That's his very first baseball glove.
You got anything more recent?
Well, only his mug shot, but I'm not supposed to have that, am I? Hello? Yes, he's here. It's for you, Mr. Nolan.
You got anything?
We found Rembrandt Landy in a back room at Pistol Pete's, but he won't talk.
Why not?
He can't. His throat's been cut.
Somebody's not fooling around.
I don't know, Lieutenant. Maybe I ought to go back to pounding a beat. This is getting grim.
You get used to it. Anybody know what happened here?
Well, the shop was closed. No witnesses, no weapon. All fingerprints are wiped out.
Looks like we're finished here, then. I'm going back to headquarters.
Yeah, I could use a breather.
Later. You're going to see the Ryan couple. First time you ever called. You got that address?
Yeah, but...
I'll meet you there in half an hour.
Stand back, everyone.
Wilson, homicide. Who's the body?
Guy's name Ryan. There's another one inside.
Out of my way. Nolan. Nolan.
Lieutenant, I can't stand it.
You look lousy.
You haven't seen Ryan's wife.
I saw Ryan. No witnesses?
And no weapon. He's some kind of maniac running around.
Yeah, and I get the feeling we're right behind him.
We're running out of leads.
Maybe not. This thing's narrowing down. I looked through the file on Slito at headquarters. I think Tattoo Ed tried to sneak a fastball by us all. Trouble is, someone hit it out of the park. Nolan? Mrs. Slito's waiting.
Do I have to go?
I'm going with you.
Please answer.
Look at it this way. If she's dead, you're in the clear.
What?
No, you found the others.
Lieutenant.
I'm joking.
Some joke.
Oh, why, Officer Wilson, you're just in time for cookies. How nice of you to come back so soon. And you brought along a friend.
Sergeant Nolan, my partner.
Ma'am?
Would you like a glass of milk?
We haven't time for that.
A cookie, then.
Mrs. Slito, your son is dead.
Lieutenant, how could you?
No. Eddie's coming back. He told me.
He told you when he was here last week.
Ma'am, maybe you should sit down.
Eddie's not really dead.
I'm sorry, but it's true.
No.
Maybe I should handle this?
He was killed by someone else who was in on that armored car robbery 7 years ago.
But how? Nobody knows.
Ed was only out of prison 3 months of the last 10 years. August of 69 was one of them. That's when the armored car payroll was stolen. The money was never recovered.
Not Eddie. Please, not my Eddie.
I leveled with you, Mrs. Slito. At least do the same for me.
Leave me alone. I don't know anything.
Lieutenant.
Who else was there? Now, 4 people have died already. We don't want any more.
I don't know. I don't know.
I'm sorry to be this way, Mrs. Slito, but I'm teed off. I liked Eddie. I respected his talent. But he didn't pull that job alone. It wasn't his style. And whoever he was working with wants that money. I want that man.
Go away.
Lieutenant.
Yeah, all right.
Ma'am, please, if you could just remember what your son might have said to you, anything.
He said the money was ours now. All he had to do was go get it. He was a good boy.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Officer?
Yes?
I don't know if it's important, but one day last week a man called here, Freddy, but he'd already gone.
Did he say who he was, leave any message?
No. He just asked Freddy. Oh, one thing, though.
Yeah?
The man spoke with a foreign accent.
You don't expect Van Ness to be here, do you?
Well, if he's sniffing all those people, he does get around. There's a car. Somebody's here.
Look, there's a light on in the lodge.
Come on. Ready?
Go ahead.
Hold it right there, mister.
Hey, what is this? What is this?
Police business. Where's Van Ness? The guy who runs the place?
Yeah? I'm Van Ness. I own Dodger Lodge. I just got in tonight from Mexico. I've been on vacation the past 3 weeks. This is an off-season.
Has anyone been here that you know of?
Only Sparky.
Sparky?
Sparky Bell, the caretaker.
Describe him.
Well, he's sort of average height, medium build.
Lieutenant?
Yeah, I hear it. Mr. Van Ness, I have some bad news for you. While you were away, a man was hacked to death and buried on your property.
What?
His name was Ed Slito. Tattoo Ed. You ever hear of him?
No, I never heard of him.
And you don't know where Sparky is now?
I just this minute got in myself.
From where?
From the airport.
Well, don't go away. Nolan, let's go see what that thumping's about.
Lieutenant, look. There, by the pilings. What is it?
An ice chest. Probably Ryan's. Open it up.
Oh,
what do you know? Slito's missing arm.
I think I'm going to be sick.
Shut it. Listen.
I don't hear you.
Kill the light. One more step and you're a dead man.
Hey, don't shoot. It's me, Van Ness.
You again. I thought I told you to stay put.
Oh, I was scared.
Scared of what?
Oh, what if Sparky's around?
What about it?
Well, he might want to kill me, too, like that other man. The one you was asking me about.
What makes you think Sparky killed Ed Slito?
You said he did.
Did I say that?
Well, you made it sound like that's what you meant.
We don't know for sure. You ever see this ice chest before?
Well, it didn't come from the lodge. We don't supply them.
It belonged to a couple named Ryan. Nice people. A little stuffy, but harmless.
Oh, but how did it get here?
The Ryans must have forgotten to take it when they left.
Ryan? I don't recall anyone by that name staying with us.
They were just here. Oh, but you were away. You couldn't have known. Kind of a strange place to keep an ice chest tied to a pier. What's inside is even stranger. Take a guess.
Oh, I'm sure I wouldn't know.
Lieutenant, there's something out there off the end of the pier.
Let's take a look.
It's a... Oh, no, not another body.
It doesn't look like we have to worry about Sparky anymore. It looks like he cut himself shaving. You know something, Van Ness? Van Ness.
Where'd he go?
Van Ness.
Come in! Get me, copper!
Lieutenant, he could be anywhere. He knows the area. Why don't we call for assistance?
No, I want this one.
But he's nuts. If he killed all those people, why did he come back here?
He had to come back to kill Sparky Bell.
Yeah, kill us too.
Maybe. I'll take that chance.
Thanks a lot.
They were all in on it. Van Ness, Sparky, and Slito. But Tattoo Ed crossed up the others. He must have buried the money right here after the robbery, then got himself sent up again to wait it out. When he came back, they were waiting for him.
Why hide it here, right under their noses?
People are always looking elsewhere for something that's right in front of them.
You shouldn't have come here! Now you're gonna die!
He's over by the lodge.
No, that's the echo. He's closer by.
Why doesn't he go up into the woods, try to get away?
The money. He hasn't found it yet.
Are you sure?
I will be as soon as it's light. I know where Slito buried it. Keep walking. He'll be coming up off your left shoulder.
What?
Don't turn around. When I say to, duck your head. Duck.
Lieutenant, stop. You'll kill him.
Okay, get up, Van Ness. You're lucky my partner's a singles hitter. I'd like to smack you all the way up into the bleachers. Let's go.
Well, I'm glad that's over with. Van Ness really was off his rocker. Imagine killing all those people for something he couldn't even find. By the way, we haven't found the money yet either.
Yes, we have.
We have?
Come on, bring the shovel. Don't you see it?
See what?
These four pines. That's what Van Ness couldn't figure out from the tattoo on Toledo's arm. All he saw was a baseball diamond. Now, if we call this tree home plate, and if we pace off 60 feet, 6 inches, we should have something.
Well, hand me that shovel, will you? Lieutenant, it's here.
Like I figured. It's all so sad, but simple just the same. Where else would Tattoo Edge Sleeto, the greatest right-handed thrower in the history of prison baseball, think to hide that stolen money? The place he knew best and loved most. Underneath the pitcher's mound.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
An Arm's Length is an original radio drama by Kim Weisskopf. Dick Sargent was heard as Detective Lieutenant Dan Wilson. Featured in the cast were Mike Ray, Alice Reinhardt, Peter Leeds, Gene Gillespie, and Jim Bowles. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colas, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.